Hi, Glow Kids, and welcome back to another week of our online Glow Kids service. We're so happy to see you. Let's get ready to worship together.
So simple, faith like a child. I give you an inch and you take me a mile. I feel the wind rush and the thunder roll. 2 feet on the water, only one way to go. Yeah, I don't gotta be afraid no more. No, 'cause I know you're up through the storm. I'm more than just a talker. I'm a
and welcome back to our series, Game Plan. We're learning how we always do our best when we follow God's plan for our lives. Have you ever had someone tell you something that was a little hard to believe? Maybe they told you something, but then they followed it up with the words, "Trust me." Those words only have meaning if the person who is saying them is actually someone that you can trust. Trust is something that is built over time. You can learn to trust someone when they prove themselves trustworthy, time and time again, right? Well, in this video, Todd learns a pretty important lesson about trust. Let's watch it.
Man, I've been learning a lot of great stuff from you, Tony. I'm really glad you decided to be my personal trainer. I know that I'm gonna make the varsity basketball team in no time.
Forget about it. I'm happy to help you, shortstop. It's like the time I was playing with NBA legend Barry Lurd.
Barry Lurd? Don't you mean Larry Bird from the Boston Celtics?
No, Barry Lurd. What a legend that guy was. He was a trainer for the Vancouver Grizzlies. He could fold a fitted sheet 4 different ways in under 30 seconds.
Okay.
Now where was I? Oh yeah, now it's time to rock today's training, okay? Now I will admit, today's exercise requires a little bit of trust on your part.
Oh yeah? Well, please tell me I'm not gonna be blindfolded.
No, not at all.
What is that for? Are you gonna put it over my mouth so I can't complain?
Nope. Perfect.
What is all this about? I can't move my arms.
Yep. Today we're going to work on your passing game.
Ow! Wait! What? How am I supposed to work on passing if I can't catch the ball?
Well, it sounds like you need a better game plan, doesn't it?
Huh?
You don't trust me, huh? Okay. Guess we gotta try something else.
Ow!
Okay. Try this.
A cheese puff? What am I supposed to do with this?
Well, you need to practice your dribbling, right?
How am I supposed to dribble with a cheese puff? It doesn't even bounce.
Wow. Still don't trust me?
What is there to trust? You're tying my hands to my side and throwing a ball at my chest, and then you're expecting me to bounce a cheese ball on the ground? None of that makes sense.
Not to you.
Not to anybody.
Well, there's a pretty important scripture that the kids are gonna learn in their lesson today that could do you a lot of good in your current situation.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, it's about not leaning on your own understanding, but trusting that God knows best. It's about not trusting in your game plan, but trusting in God's.
Oh, so kind of like how I'm not trusting in your game plan right now.
Exactly. Sometimes God asks us to do something that doesn't even make sense to our own understanding, but if we trust God and obey, He will show us the right path to take.
Gotcha. I guess I need to pay attention to that lesson, huh?
Would be a good idea. Now, where were we?
Cheese ball.
Yeah, you see, the reason why I picked...
Trust is not an easy thing. Sometimes we can find it hard to trust others, but we can always trust God. He will always come through for us and lead us onto the right path. We're going to learn all about that in our lesson today, but right now, let's check in with Callie from the Valley. She's going to teach you what you got to know.
You know I got to tell you what you got to know. Tell you what you got to know. You know I got to tell you what you got to know. Tell you what you got to know.
Hey kids, it's me, Callie from the Valley, and I'm like, here to tell you like what you gotta know. Today we're like talking about trusting God no matter what, right? So every time today somebody asks you what you gotta know, you tell them, I will trust in the Lord with all of my heart. It's like tough out there. Christians don't always know what to do, you know? It's like, what do I do? What's the plan for my life? Like, who even am I? Like, what if God's plans, like, don't even make sense? You know? Yeah. Even when we're thinking like that, we have to, like, trust God. He knows what He's doing, like, okay? So, every time today somebody asks you what you gotta know, you tell them, I will trust in the Lord with all of my heart. And that is what you gotta know. I'm Callie from the Valley saying TTYL. Oh my Lanta, like what you gotta know?
Today's Bible story is found in Matthew chapter 14. Jesus had just finished teaching a large group of people and wanted to go be alone for a while and pray. So he sent his disciples out in a boat to cross the sea. All of a sudden, when they were out there in the middle of the night, a huge storm came. The disciples started freaking out. They all thought that they were going to die. Then, just when they thought it couldn't get any worse, they looked up and saw the figure of a person coming towards them. The disciples thought it was a ghost. They began to get really scared. First, there was this big storm, and now there was a ghost coming after them. So, it definitely was not a ghost, though. Do you know who it was? Jesus, that's right. He was walking on the water and coming out to be with them in the storm. Suddenly, Peter yelled out to Jesus, Lord, if it's really you, let me come out and walk on the water with you. Jesus said, come on. So Peter did something that most of us would probably think was crazy. He stepped out of the boat in the middle of the storm and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. Can you imagine walking on water in the middle of a storm? That had to be an incredible experience. Peter kept walking on the water toward Jesus, focusing on his Lord, who was just a few feet away. Then, suddenly, Peter did something that really messed him up. He began to look around at all of the waves that were surrounding him, the storm, the rain, and he began to get a little scared, a lot scared. Suddenly, after Peter took his eyes off Jesus and started focusing on the storm, he began to sink. Peter thought he was gonna drown. He cried out to Jesus to save him, and Jesus reached out his hand to Peter and pulled him up out of the water, setting him into the boat. Peter was saved. Jesus looked at Peter and said, "You have such little faith. Why did you doubt?" Peter felt ashamed because he had stopped focusing on Jesus and having faith in him and had instead started focusing on the storm that was around him. Today, you're going to learn that in order to succeed in God's game plan, you have to trust him. You have to focus on him and not lean on your own understanding. Pay attention. This lesson could change your life.
Why, hello everyone! My name is Rita Teest, but nobody goes by Rita anymore, so you can just call me R. Teest. Now, I've just been working on my newest painting, but I really need to take a break, so I thought you could help me with today's power verse. The problem is, I sleepwalk at night, and last night I was painting today's power verse, and I started using pictures instead of words. So now I need your help to figure out what it's supposed to say. Let's take a look at it. Trust in the Lord with all your organs? Oh my, boys and girls, what is that? Oh, heart. Do tie. No, do rope. Huh. Oh, it's a knot. Knot. Depend on your own brain. Mind? Boys and girls, what could that word be? Oh, I know it. It's understanding. Seek his tire? Round thingy? What is that, boys and girls? A wheel. Oh, you know what that sounds like. Will. In all you do, and he will show, oh, I know this, it's you. Which path to take? Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. That's it! Great job, boys and girls. Now, let's make sure that we don't forget it. So everyone stand up and say it with me on the count of three. One, two, three. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek his will in all you do, and he will show you which path to take. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Great job, everyone. You can all have a seat. Now, would you like to see today's painting? I know you would. See, this one is a portrait of my grandmother. Ta-da! Isn't she so beautiful? She's eating her favorite food, mac and cheese. And she just got her hair did. It looks so fabulous. Work it, Gram-Gram. Ooh, ooh. Anyway, thank you all so much for your help today. I'll see you later, boys and girls. Bye-bye.
are four words that are on every piece of U.S. money. Do you know what those words are? In God we trust. These words are not only important for our nation, but they're also important for each and every person who is a follower of Jesus. Our power verse today says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek his will in all you do, and he will show you which path to take. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. There are several lessons that we can learn from this verse. I can always trust God. God created each and every one of you. He knew exactly what you were going to look like, what you were going to be like, and what you're going to be when you grow up, even before you were ever even born. God loves you and has a plan for your life, and you can trust him to take care of you and lead you throughout your life. What does it mean, though, to trust God? Trust is a really important thing, and it requires a person to believe that the other person wants to and is able to do the right thing. We can certainly trust God because we know that he wants to and that he is able to take care of us, lead us, and direct us, right? But sadly, many times we don't really trust him the way that this verse is meant to be and the way that this verse teaches us. You see, I can't trust God halfway. I must trust him with all my heart. Our power verse says that we are to trust God with all of our heart. That means we must trust him all of the time, in all situations, in all areas of our life. Many times we say all, but what we really are saying is most. We say, God, I trust you, but we hold back areas of our lives that we want to still maintain and control. You know, areas like the friends that we have or the music that we listen to and the things that we like to do. Our verse today says we are to trust God with all of our heart and seek his will in all we do. That means that we can't hold anything back. If we will trust God with all of our heart and we will seek him in all that we do, then what does God promise to do? Our power verse tells us, it says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek his will in all you do. And do you remember it? ... He will show you which path to take. If I seek his will, he will show me his game plan. So what does it mean for God to lead us on the right path? It's like this. If this is when we're born and this is when we die, and we trust God with all of our heart and seek him with all that we do, then he will lead us down a straight path that he has planned for us. Without God, our path would look crazy like this. It would look absolutely crazy, but God has an amazing plan for all of us. That's why we must trust the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek him in all you do, and he will show you what path to take. So let's pray together. Bow your heads and close your eyes. Father, I pray for the kids who are listening and even their parents and their siblings, that they would submit their lives to you and trust you with all of their heart. I ask them right now to think of anything that they're holding back from you. And I pray that they would make a decision to seek you in all that you do, and that you would show them the path to take. In Jesus' name, amen. Guys, we love you so much. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you Sunday. And if not Sunday, we'll see you right here next Saturday at noon. We love you. Have a great weekend. See you then. Bye.